So we're back with another eToro portfolio update. Now, of course, if you watched the video last week, Friday, you would have seen that I was in the hole for about $2,300 and some change. And that, of course, representing about a 48% loss on my portfolio. A lot of that to do with the fact that, of course, I was heavily invested in cryptocurrency. And as I mentioned in that video, of course, this eToro portfolio is not my main portfolio, and I'm using this for educational purposes for the channel. And so this week has passed, and I have been doing some very interesting trades and doing some interesting things with my portfolio. And as it stands right now, I've managed to pull my portfolio back by another $700. So that means I've managed to regain about 10.48% of my portfolio's losses. And I'm going to go through some detail in this video, how I've done it, exactly what I've been doing, and really help you understand what you can do in times when your portfolio is not looking so good and the options that you have to improve things. And of course, the key thing to remember is that you only actually truly lose money when you sell. So, you know, as long as you hold on to it and it hopefully goes up in the future at some point, and you're prepared to hold on long enough, well, you can avoid those losses. In this case, I really wanted to get out of cryptocurrency. If you guys have been following the channel and watching all of the cryptos that I've been reviewing, I'm losing faith in cryptocurrency extremely fast, although I am still bullish on one or two cryptos, and I have very specific reasons for that. And I'll probably touch on that a little bit in this video, but I wanted to just quickly give you guys an update and show you what I've been doing in my portfolio. And of course, as I promised, I'm going to be completely transparent with you guys. I'm going to show you everything I do in the portfolio. And I'm actually going to build this portfolio out in front of you guys over the next couple of months. I'm actually hoping to take this up to, you know, at least a couple of $1,000 over the next couple of months, more than it is right now, and show you guys the exact purchases we're making, how we're making them, why we're making them, and we'll show you the real-time profits and real-time losses. So with that said, let's jump straight into my screen here and let me show you guys where we're at. So of course, I just want to quickly play through a little bit of last week's clip in case you missed it, just to show you exactly where we were, and then we'll come on to today's portfolio and see where we're at.
$758 allocated to the account. There is a loss on the account currently of $2,436, and the total equity left is $4,412.17.
Okay, so we can see $6,758 allocated to the account. I haven't added any more money to the account, so pretty much just been working what was within in the account. I was at a loss of 2,346.12 with equity of 4,412.18. Now, let's go and have a look at my live portfolio and see exactly what's going on. So I'm just going to move the screen around a bit so you guys can see exactly what's going on. As of right now, and this is live numbers and live stats, we can see still the same amount allocated that I had last month, although the loss has decreased to 1,608, and my equity is now up to 5,185. So I've pretty much gone up about $700. Now, I want to talk you guys through some of the trades, and I also want to show you what I'm currently holding. So I'm going to quickly go back on my historical trades here and just show you exactly what I've been doing over the last couple of days. So I just want to increase the date range. We've got on 30 days so you guys can see exactly what happened. So of course, Ethereum and Cardano, the prices were going up quite drastically, and I decided to average out of my positions. Now, this is obviously a strategy that you have to think about quite clearly. So one of my concerns was that the prices would not continue to rise and that they would maybe fall back a little bit. So what I decided to do was average out of my positions. So I'm gonna show you some of these over here. So of course, I got out of Cardano here, I took a little bit of a loss. I got out here, took a little bit of a loss. I got out here and got out dead even. Got out here with a small profit, and this on Ethereum, I took a little bit of profit, and I took a little bit of profit. So I pretty much averaged out at a net profit, although it wasn't a hell of a lot. So I then took that money and decided to buy into some proper stocks, because you know, one of the things that I've been saying for a long period of time is if you really want to do well in the market, you have to buy stocks with good fundamentals. And if you are going to speculate, by all means speculate, but do it with a small portion of your portfolio. So what I've done is I've started to create a portfolio here on eToro that takes into account a little bit of speculation, but a lot of stability in terms of the stocks. Now, first thing I want to quickly just show you guys is what's happened on my portfolio in the last couple of days. So of course, looking at this, I'm up 17.24% in my trade so far. And This is what happens when you start to actively manage your portfolio. So I've had a decent build-up. I've obviously got out of some really bad positions, and I'm really hoping for some more cryptos to go up. Doge, really hoping for Doge to go up so that we can get out of that position. As soon as Doge gets to a profitable part on this portfolio, I'm definitely going to be selling off. Of course, I do still have Doge and a couple of other cryptocurrencies that I'm really speculating on in my Binance account. And so for this eToro account and for the purpose of this being a public-facing portfolio, I really want to show you guys how to trade profitably and how to invest profitably. So let's go and have a look at my portfolio and see what I've been doing. So obviously I've included a couple of new stocks. And obviously a lot of these stocks I actually already own in my Interactive Brokers account. So some of them I've put in here as high growth potential, others just to show you guys over the long term what good solid stocks can do. So coming down, and let's go from profit to loss, or should I say from loss to profit. So obviously right down at the bottom, I'm currently 52% down on Doge. I'm currently down almost 50% on Link, and XRP down 27%. Now, I'm also in Kinross Gold. I'm currently at -8.47. And just to be precise, Kinross Gold is actually a hedge for me at the moment, because obviously that's a gold play. And so I'm using it as a small hedge in this portfolio. You can see only about $200 allocated to it. Then I've got Coupang, which I've spoken about a few times. It's a growth stock, which I think is going to do really well over the next year to 2 years. So I started to include that. And that's why you'll see it's got a slightly smaller position on this portfolio than the other stocks. And obviously, the more money I allocate to something in terms of the portfolio, the less risky I think it is. Then I've got Pinterest in here. I've got Nokia, or Nokia, as our overseas viewers would call it. And also, we've got Taiwan Semiconductor. We've got Intel. We've got Shell. And we've got another speculation play here, although I'm very bullish on this one. So definitely go and check it out. That's Gevo. They're doing some interesting things in the biofuel space. Their fundamentals are a little bit off. So it is a bit of a speculation, but I've been doing a lot of reading and a lot of research, and I think there's potentially some good things in there. And then, of course, I've spoken about Harmony Gold a number of times. Harmony Gold is in there. Again, another hedge in my portfolio. And that's why you'll see it's allocated a slightly different amount to the other investments that I've made. I've also got Toyota in here. I've got AMD. And then I've got an index fund, because I really wanted to show you guys over the long term what an index fund does. So specifically on Vanguard, they've got a number of index funds. I've chosen to use the SPY, which is basically the S&P 500. And I'm in on that, and really for no other reason than to show you guys what the potential returns on this could be over a couple of years. And then we've got Tesla, which is up a little bit at the moment. We've got EPD, which Darvin and I have spoken about quite extensively in our videos. We've of course got Pfizer, AstraZeneca, and then of course Snap. And the most profitable in the portfolio at the moment by the top three is Snapchat, which has given us a 3.29% return since we added it last week, which is not bad. AstraZeneca, which I've spoken about in my videos as well. And of course EPD. And then Pfizer doing pretty well as well. Great thing about Pfizer is, of course, and EPD, they have great dividends on their stock. So that's also going to kick into the portfolio. So yeah, as it stands right now, we're definitely up in the portfolio. Things are looking a lot better. And yeah, I've been ensuring that we get out of those cryptocurrencies. If we come back here, we can see that I currently only hold three cryptocurrencies in this portfolio, but they do have a significant portion. If we add this up, it's $750, almost $3,100 of the total $6,700 in here. So I've currently got just under 50% of my portfolio allocated in cryptocurrency, and that's something I definitely wouldn't recommend. So I really hope that this video stays up and does really well over time and gets a lot of viewing and a lot of traction, because I'd like you guys to see what not to do. And this is a great example of what not to do. You should never put too much of your money into cryptocurrency. You should definitely not put too much of your money into something that's highly speculative. And so with that in mind, That is exactly why I want to average out of these positions. So as soon as XRP gets close to, you know, being neutral or goes a little bit over profit, I'm going to average out of that. I'll do the same with LINK. I'll do the same with Doge. And of course, I'm going to keep my speculation of cryptocurrency in a hot or in a cold wallet, a hard cold wallet. And I'll basically check in on it once a year or once every year and a half and really just set it and forget it. You know, it's basically money I'm prepared to lose anyway. So I hope you guys have enjoyed looking inside the portfolio. I hope you've enjoyed looking at some of the moves I've been making this week to basically pull my portfolio back by about $700. And as I mentioned, if you have a look at September already, we are, so I click on my statistics here, we can see that I'm up for September 17.24. And a lot of that has to do with picking the right stocks, but also getting out of those damn cryptocurrency positions. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you've got any questions about averaging out of positions that you've got, if you've got any questions about positions I've taken, if you've got any questions about specific stocks that I've chosen, please let me know in the comment section down below and I'd be happy to answer those. And of course, next week Friday, I'm gonna give the same update again. I'm gonna try and do this on a regular basis on a Friday so that you guys can see exactly what I've been doing in the portfolio. And I'm of course, again, going to call on Davi to do the same. I managed to get him to open up his portfolio last week, so definitely check his video out. I'll link to it in the link card up above here. And Davi, do the right thing. Show us your portfolio on a weekly basis. We'd all love to see it. And of course, Davi making some very different plays to me. So it's great to see what two different investors are doing from two different perspectives. So hope you enjoyed the video and we'll see you guys next week. And of course, make sure you're around for the live streams because we have loads of great live streams all already scheduled for next week. So go check on our live streams up and coming tab on the homepage and you'll see we've got five incredible live streams lined up. So we'll see you guys next week. Before you go, I'd like to invite you to subscribe to our channel and join the Global Money Tribe. And because I know you need a little bit of extra motivation every month, I'm going to be giving away a signed copy of my book, The Money Secret, as well as some really cool channel merch. So if that's not a big enough motivation to subscribe, come and subscribe for the content because every single day we're adding absolutely great content teaching you to invest, save, and manage your money situation.